Hello everyone, it's time for another Photoshop tutorial. And in this video, I want to show you a cool little trick how you can add realistic and awesome looking motion to the clouds in your landscape photos. So instead of having rather static and chaotic looking clouds like in this case, we are going to use the path blur filter of Photoshop to create something like this. And I have to say, this will be a really easy tutorial, so if you want to follow along, you can find a download link to this exact photo in the description of the video and try this method yourself. Alright, so here we have the base image, and the goal is to add some motion to the clouds in the back. Of course, we only want to have the motion on the clouds and not the lighthouse in the foreground. So the very first thing I want to do is to just duplicate that image by hitting Ctrl J. And now I'm turning off the background layer for a moment. And with the top layer selected, I'm applying a layer mask. And since we want the foreground, so everything except the sky, to stay the same, I'm going to use this layer mask right here to mask out the sky. And therefore I'm setting the foreground color to black. Grab the brush tool and just start to paint over the sky. And the cool thing here is you don't need to be exact, you can do everything pretty roughly around here. But of course, the more precise you are doing this, the better the final result. But in this case, something like this works totally fine. So now we have a nicely cut out lighthouse and foreground. And if we now would blur the background layer, the lighthouse itself wouldn't be affected by the blur. So for example, if I would just apply a radial blur, let's increase the amount a little bit. You can see the lighthouse is still sharp as it should be. But this brings us to the next problem. Now let me turn off the foreground layer real quick. Now as you can see, since we still have a lighthouse in the background layer, this one will also get blurred. Now when I'm turning back on the lighthouse layer, you can see the blurred lighthouse in the back shining through, and that's something we don't want. So we have to do some minor editing on the background layer as well. Again, let me turn off the foreground layer, and on this background layer we simply want to get rid of the lighthouse. And in this case, it's pretty easy. I'm just selecting the lasso tool and then I'm creating a rough selection around the lighthouse. Something like this is totally fine. And then I'm hitting Shift F5 to fill this area. And under contents, I'm simply using the content aware. So Photoshop will get rid of this area automatically. As you can see, this works really good. And now I have a separate layer for the lighthouse and the background. Of course, now I could just use the radial blur as I just did for the example, which I mentioned previously, but this looks rather unrealistic since normally with long exposure photos, clouds would move in lots of different directions and not always that straight. For this reason, with the background layer selected, I'm going to the filters menu, go to blur gallery, and then simply choose path blur. Once Photoshop has opened it up, you can already see it has a slight blur applied already. In this case, I don't want it, so I'm clicking on it and just hit the delete key. Instead, we want to apply our own blur directions. And we can do that by simply clicking in the image and dragging a path in our desired direction. And now you can see all the clouds will move in this direction. The cool thing though about this path is you can add some curvature by clicking on the path and dragging it up or down. And add some nice motion to your clouds. So let's see, I want the clouds to go away from the lighthouse. So on the other side, I'm dragging a path to the other direction. And let's also add some curves here. And maybe let's add a path like this. And one here going a little bit more upwards. And again, just add some curves there. And let's continue on the other side. And one straight up as well. Right now, the blur effect isn't that strong. Of course, if you want to change it, you can simply go to the speed settings right there and increase the speed. Alright, and once you are satisfied with the result, just hit the OK button up there. Photoshop will now take a moment to apply this filter. And once that's done, that's already it for this nice motion effect. So instead of having a static, boring sky like this, we have applied a nice looking blur effect to this landscape photo. So I hope this video was interesting and helpful. Of course, if you have any questions, please feel free to ask in the comments. And thank you very much for watching this video.